that that night, look at all the woman here. It's twisted. Hold on. Put the pull longer into the floor, right? There we go. Did you know the night that Jesus gave his life for us, that night, he changed everything. He put an exclamation point on everything the Bible says about him. He put that exclamation point on because he died for our sins. Because he loved us. Oh, gosh, on that night, he washed feet of his disciples. Now they were like, Lord, what are you doing? You're the rabbi, you're the teacher. What the heck are you doing? And Jesus said, this is who you used to be. You need to be servant of all. You're not better than them. You then spread his word. You're never better than them. Those people. They just don't have Jesus yet. And so on that night, during supper, he took bread. And he raised it up to heaven like he did so many times before. And he blessed it. Just as he did, you know, blessing the food for the 5,000. He blessed it. And he broke it. And he gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat, all of you. This is my body that is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And so at supper, he also took the cup. Changed it all around. He became that Passover lamb that night. Praise God, thank you, Jesus. And he raised it. And he blessed it. And he took the cup and he said, take, drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of Jesus Christ and his mighty acts, we can proclaim loud and clear the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, and Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us, gather here and on these gifts of bread and the vine. May they be to us the body and blood of Christ. May we leave here redeemed, renewed, refreshed. May we be one in Christ, one in each other, one in ministry, until we feast at that final banquet. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen.